Hello everybody, today we're going to make a broomstick. Let's make the stick first. Inflate a brown balloon leaving about 1 inch flat tail. Twist the first soft about 5 inch long bubble. Then we twist the second soft about 5 inch long bubble. And then we lock both ends of the chain of the first two bubbles in one lock twist. Let's force the nozzle or nut of the brown balloon between bubbles to secure the lock. Now we lock all ends of the first two bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the third soft about 5 inch long brown bubble. Lock both ends of the third brown bubble in one lock twist. The rest of the balloon is the fourth bubble. This way we have made the handle for the broom or the stick. Now I'm going to use second balloon, yellow color, to make the broom. Inflate yellow balloon leaving about 5 inch flat tail. First we have to attach the yellow balloon to the brown, to our stick. So let's lock the nozzle of the yellow balloon between brown bubbles. I'm going to make the broom in very much the same way as we did a pumpkin in one of the previously published instructions. Let's twist the first soft about 5 inch long yellow bubble. Twist the second soft about 5 inch long yellow bubble. Then we lock both ends of the chain of the first two yellow bubbles in one lock twist. After that we twist the third soft 5 inch long yellow bubble. And then we lock free end of the third yellow bubble between the first and the second yellow bubbles. We are making here bird body twist. To make the bird body twist, we have to roll the first and the second bubbles around the third bubble. We have made the bird body twist. Now we twist the fourth soft about 5 inch long yellow bubble. And we lock the free end of the fourth yellow bubble between the brown bubbles. Basically, we have already made the broom. If you think it's good enough, then you can cut off the rest of the yellow balloon and tie off the end. Or you can add a couple more yellow bubbles to the broom. I'm going to twist the fifth soft about 5 inch long yellow bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last two yellow bubbles in one lock twist. So again, we're making the bird body twist. Usually we make the bird body twist using just 3 bubbles. In this example we are making bird body twist using 5 bubbles. It makes it a bit harder to make the bird body twist. However, the sculpture looks better with 5 bubbles, in my opinion. Let's roll the 5th bubble couple more times between yellow bubbles of the broom. I'm doing it just to secure the lock twist. And we can twist the 6th soft about 5 inch long yellow bubble. And we lock the free end of the 6th yellow bubble between the brown bubbles of the broomstick. The rest of the balloon is the 7th bubble, we don't need it. You can cut it off and tie off the end. Or you can simply hide it between bubbles, between yellow bubbles of the broom. Generally, I don't like to cut balloons. It's better to keep balloons intact. This way the balloon keeps the shape better and stays longer inflated. Fix all bubbles in proper positions. Congratulations, we have made the broomstick. Here's a side view. And that is a bottom view. It is a nice toy, you can use it as it is. Also we can use the broomstick as addition to the witch sculpture. Here's a witch. I have made it in advance. We can attach the broomstick to the witch in different ways. I like to make witch flying on a broomstick. Simply pull the brown bubble of the broomstick between bubbles of the legs. And then we force the brown bubble of the broomstick through the loop of arm bubbles of the witch. Now let's fix all bubbles in proper positions. I think it's better to slide the witch down to the bottom of the broomstick. Here's a side view, back view. has a front view. Alright, that's enough for today. Have fun and happy twisting.